Hawks lose 4-0 to the St. Louis Blues tonight. And they had no effort on the ice as it looked. They may have gotten shots on the net, but they were not high quality at all. The Chicago Blackhawks losing 4-0 to their arch rival St. Louis Blues. This is ridiculous how they played. 3 games in a row now, losing to division opponents, two games in a row losing to the division. How did they go from winning games in the division last season to being one of the worst teams in divisional play? I don't know. It's ridiculous. The Hawks managed coming out with 38 shots on net, yes, but they weren't high quality. St. Louis had 30 shots on net, and the majority of them were pretty high quality opportunities. The team looked like they were playing not to play, if you understand what I mean. It looked more like they are at that point where they're tired of listening to Jeremy Colliton's monotone voice behind the bench. I would be okay if that's what it is, to try and get him fired. Usually when teams start showing that they're giving up on their head coach, they look like they aren't skating as much. They may put up the shots, but it just seems like that's what's going on here. The Hawks lose their 3rd straight game, and now they lose to the St. Louis Blues in the fact that they're the division rivals. They need to pick it up and play hockey. They're the Hawks currently drop to a record of 10-12-5. That there is unacceptable. And we have a harder matchup on Thursday night, taking on the Boston Bruins, who only have 3 losses in the regular season. Yes, 3 losses. Hawks losing 4-0 to St. Louis? Honestly, unacceptable. And you're losing to Jake Allen in net. Yeah. Jake Allen and Nat. I don't know what is up with the Hawks lately, but they just look like they don't care. They out-hit St. Louis 30-27, but on the power play, Hawks did not do anything. They were just passing the puck around and not shooting the puck. You are on a power play. Shoot the puck. St. Louis had 2 power plays. They scored on their first one. I don't know what is going on here with the Hawks. They are playing like they don't care. So let's get into the goals of the game because it's all St. Louis. Why not? It's ridiculous. In the first period at 2:34 in the first period, scored by McKenzie McInerney, I think that's how you pronounce his name, on the backhand. Crawford tries playing the puck when the puck goes off the boards behind him. Crawford couldn't get to play the puck. The defenders for the Hawks on the ice were thinking Curl will play the puck. So they decided to skate back and let McInerney, I believe that's how you pronounce his name, I honestly don't know, walk in and just score, and the assist went to Vince Dunn to make it 1-0 St. Louis. Goal scoring's not done though in the first period. On the power play, off a tip-in with a net front presence of Schwartz, his 8th of the season, assisted by Pietrangelo and Perron. Net front presence, tipping the puck in, giving the Blues a 2-0 lead at the end of 2. There was no fight in that period by the Hawks. It seemed like they just looked like they were not in the game at all. So let's talk about the shots on net in that first period. 10 for St. Louis, 10 for the Hawks. So even match up in the first period. But honestly, I wouldn't say it's even. The St. Louis Blues outplayed the Hawks by playing to the Hawks playing into St. Louis's favor by playing off the boards. That's something you don't want to do against one of the bigger bodied teams in the NHL that's one of the slower teams in the NHL. They want to hit, and playing to the boards is not the style of play to play against a team that's bigger in size than the Chicago Blackhawks. The Hawks are not, by size comparison, the Hawks are much smaller than the Blues, and they should have the advantage in speed. And they do, but they just did not use their speed for advantage tonight. Brandon Saad had a few opportunities tonight. He probably was our best player on the ice. Corey Crawford was in net, yes, and he played well, but the defense left him out to dry yet again. We go to the second period. No goals were scored. There were two power plays in that period. Nothing came from them. So we go to the third period. At 8:56 in the third period, Shin from Walker and Schwartz to make it 3-0. It was a one-time shot first on Shin, and he gets it off a rolling puck, and it goes over Corey Crawford's blocker side. And also, I want to mention Crawford started the game off in his new Bauer gear and ended the game out in his CCM pads. I think he may prefer his CCM stuff because it could be still broken in comparison to his Bauer gear. So the Blues now have a 3-0 lead. But at 18:11, thank you, Ole Mata, giving St. Louis the freaking 4-0 lead. Mata tried clearing the puck out of the defensive zone, but it sauces right to Tyler Bozak, where Bozak slap shots the puck past Crawford to give the Blues the 4-0 win over the Hawks. Mata, that was on him. The team just looked like they left their goalie out to dry yet again, and that's the one kiss of death this team is having all season. Every time I've noticed, whenever they do lose, it's more so them leaving their goalie out to dry and them not going for those high quality opportunities for rebounds, going for the net front presence. They're just not skating well when they do lose. I don't know what's going on with this team at this moment. It's getting ridiculous. They need to fix something quick. Maybe a trade. I don't know. It's just at this point, the Hawks are looking like they want to leave their goalies out to dry, and that's not a method of success. I don't know what is going on here. The Hawks need to find their momentum fast. I know they are went into this game shorthanded the entire game by skating 11 forwards, 6 defensemen, but still, they need to find that spark and find it quick. I don't know what else to say. It's getting out of hand where the Hawks are just losing games that they should play well in. I don't know what else to say. Losing to a rival like St. Louis is even worse. I hate losing to St. Louis, and honestly, all Hawks fans would agree on this. But still, I don't know what's going on here with this team. They need to fix their issues quickly before all things go out of hand and this season's a complete wash. At this point, it is. And honestly, as you know, from my from the beginning of this season, I said the Hawks will be battling for a wild card this year. Right now, they just don't look like they are going to. DeBrincat only has 5 goals on the season. And I predicted him to have 50 in the year, which, honestly, that is honest backfire on myself saying that. I still thought DeBrincat, being a lethal goal scorer, could actually do something like that. But it's just not working. Too many line changes from Jeremy Colleton, and it does not help the team build chemistry. I want to see the Hawks find their chemistry, make consistent lines, and play Hawks hockey. Meaning, play good hockey to grind out a good win. When they were on the winning streak, they were doing that. But now they have the injuries. That's when the injury bug happens. You need to find that spark during that time of adversity and make it where you can play good hockey. But the Hawks have not found that yet. They need to get to their game quick if they want to still compete. There's still plenty of time left in this season, but right now it's getting out of hand. So down there in the comments down below, I want to hear what your thoughts are from what the Hawks should do going into their next games to maybe find their game again and play some good hockey. But at this point, I just don't know what else to say. So thank you for watching the broadcast. Please leave a like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. I know you did not enjoy the outcome, but most of all, let's go Hawks and fix the issues quick.